Today I have five, just five products that I instantly fell in love with the first time I tried. Let's take a look at what they are. Hi, my friends. I decided that since my videos can get so windy and so long, that I was going to whittle this down to just five products that I'm loving at the moment. These are products that I have bought recently that have just all of a sudden became favorites. Now, I will say that there is a group of products that I kind of grouped into one that I've had for a little while. They classified as those that I have fallen in love with instantly, and you'll see why in just a second. I do hope that you enjoy having a little bit more succinct video where I can go into a little bit more depth with the product and share with you why I like it and have the video still be a little bit shorter. So let's get into these five products that I instantly fell in love with so that you can see whether or not there's something that you might like as well. Okay, so here's why I was saying that there was a group of products, and you'd see why I was saying that they're not newer to me. This is from Nabla, and the first thing is the skin glazing one, and this one is in Truth, and then this one is in Ozone. Now, some of these can be very blush-like because they're darker. I think these are so good. They're actually fantastic. But I also fell in love with instantly this skin bronzing, and this one is in Soft Revenge. This is not a new product to me. I've shown it to you guys many times. It's a very cool toned bronzer that I use all the time and I love. It isn't too stark. It's super easy to blend, but that's why I was showing it to you with these group, because I think these baked products that they have are phenomenal. So I have three. I forgot I had three. I actually originally got the one called Ozone. This is an absolutely gorgeous highlighter. It's a very beaming highlighter that just looks so bright and so luminous without having any glitter in it whatsoever. It's just a glow. And most of these have that kind of a glow in them. Some of them have less, but they have the pretty glow in them. Let's look at Truth. That's the other one that I got that is just glowy. This is the one that I've been using as a blush, but kind of almost as a blush topper, because as you can see right there, it does have just a little bit of that glow in it. Reminds me very much of the Milani baked blushes and the Laura Geller baked blushes, same type of thing. And then the other one that I have, this one I use a lot as a blush, and it's called Independence. And I got all these when the sale was on, and I'm so glad I did. These are so incredible. The blush formula is so good on it. That baked formula just seems to hug my cheeks, and it really doesn't show off any texture. They're beautiful. They're very pretty. And these pans, oh my goodness, I have had this one that is the contour. I know I've had it for almost 2 years and I've barely made a dip in it. These will last you a very long time. I love these. I think they're absolutely gorgeous. And then quickly, I want to also tell you that I don't know what train I fell off of or what wagon I fell off of, but I had never tried the Tarte Park Avenue Princess bronzer before. This is gorgeous. First of all, the packaging is so much fun. It's got the embossed raised up letters on there. It's almost like it's a faux leather on there. I think it's great. It's got a mirror in there. You could carry it in your purse. This bronzer, though, I want to show you on this other hand so it's not competing with anything else. This bronzer, there goes the little protective film, is amazing for somebody that has medium to fair skin. Anywhere in there, I think you're going to love this. It has just the most soft look. You can buff this on and on and on, and it's not going to get to where it's looking like it's too much on your face. I'm gonna just take my fan brush and I'm gonna go in, and I can link that fan brush for you guys too. I'm gonna go in and I'm just dusting this across my forehead and down my nose, and just to bronze and bring some more glow to my skin, like I need more anyway. This is so beautiful. It's almost on the side of being more of a, like a dark powder. It is not anything that has a glow in it. It's very matte. It leans towards the side of being more red than having any orange or yellow in it. And that works so good for people that have a cooler tone. I love this. When I got it, I was like, woo, that is so cool. And since I did that, let's just take Truth and we're gonna go across it a little bit with this. Now that is a lot. I'm gonna kind of dust that off on my fingers a little bit. And then I'm gonna just put a little bit right here so you can see how glowy and how pretty that is. Isn't that beautiful? Oh man, and even over here, my cheek got a little bit too dark with my bronzer, but oh my goodness, it just gives the most beautiful ethereal glow to your skin. I'm very glowy today. Right, the third thing that I fell in love with, and I am so glad I found this. I've been raving about the Tatcha Liquid Silk Canvas Primer. It's gorgeous. It costs a lot. This is the Kiko Milano Charming Escape Watery Blurring Primer. This is good. This is really, really, really good. It, first of all, is very watery. Comes out green. I don't know why they put green in there, but it comes out green. You can see it drip down my hand. It's very watery, but it feels more watery than the Tatcha does. So it feels hydrating, but then as you work it in, and as I'm going across my hand, I'm working it in, and it gets that gripping feeling to it, but I can also feel the blurring property, which is the dimethicone or the silicone in it. So it has all those properties of being hydrating, of smoothing, of gripping your primer, or I'm sorry, gripping your foundation. It just feels gorgeous. I'm going to pick another one of these up because what Kiko does, and it kind of, I don't know why they do that, but they do go in and out of products because they change over their line a lot. There are a few things that have been staples, but they have a tendency to not keep things in. So I'm going to get another one of these because I think it's really an awesome product. And I did use it today as my primer and my foundation just lay across it and it was just beautiful. So I really fell in love with that one very quickly. And now that I'm feeling my hand, it just feels silky, like the Tatcha. It's so pretty. I just love that. The next thing is this 5-pack of Revlon Super Lustrous Glosses. Again, what rock have I been living under? These glosses are awesome. They're so pretty. And you get 5 of them in this little box. You don't need the dog hair though. And let me turn this one around. They are so beautiful. These colors are beautiful. I have been living in all of them. I just have been trying them, having fun, playing with them. I'm gonna put this maroon looking one. It's not really maroon. It's kind of more like a, I don't know, a plum, a light plum color. And I'm gonna put this one on top of what I have on. It did change the color just a tiny bit, but it still gave a lot of depth. So it has on the doe foot applicator, there's a little well in there, which you probably won't be able to see very good. But it's, you dip it in there, and so then you have that little well to work with. And I'll just go ahead and swatch these for you. So this is the deepest one. Then there is the bright pink one. None of these carry a lot of opacity to them. So you're getting a lot of gloss with a little bit of color in it. And then there is this nude one, which is so pretty to wear with any lip liner. Just so pretty. Goes so well with all the lip liners. And then there's this sparkly pink one. And I will try as I'm going along here to throw these names up on the screen. That is a sparkly pink one. And then the last one is like a champagne color. So you're not getting a ton of color, but you are getting a beautiful array of just lip toppers, glosses that last a really long time. They're very easy to wear. They're not sticky. It's a pillowy gloss. I think I like these every bit as much as I like Fenty and every bit as much as I like Buxom. I'm sorry that the light is coming in on my face here and there like that. It's just, yeah, the light is coming straight in even though my blinds are closed. So I've been really loving these. Now, the last thing that I have to show you is this. This is an angled concealer brush from Sephora. Now, if you don't know already, Sephora is having their sale and the 20% off is a one-time only coupon that you can use for the Beauty for All. So it doesn't matter what level, what tier you are on their Beauty Insider program, whether you're VIB, Rouge, or the Beauty Insider, it doesn't matter because you can get the 20% off one time with the code GIFTEASY until the 12th. Now, this brush though is part of the Sephora collection and everything in the Sephora collection is 30% off and you can do it over and over again. So all you have to do is put this in your cart, go to your checkout, and as you're checking out, it'll take the discount off. This is the coolest brush. It is so very close to the Angie Hot and Flashy one from BK Beauty. And I know that so many of you have been waiting for this brush to become a single because you're like, well, I don't want the whole set, but I want that brush. It is a little bit smaller. As you can see, it's a little bit more dense. The BK Beauty one is super duper soft. And if you can get it, it's the one that I would choose. But if you can't afford that and you need to just have a single one, or you know you don't want that whole entire set, this is a great alternative, I feel like. And it's just called the concealer brush. And it's, to me, it's very soft. I do my corrector and my concealer with it today. It's a great find. I mean, I fell in love with this brush from BK Beauty like instantly and knew it was the star of that set. But this one, again, same thing. You can fall in love with it immediately too because it does its job so well of making sure that it's blending and putting all of that concealer right where it needs to be and just blending it out like a dream. So I was really happy I found this one and fell in love with it immediately too. That's my five products. That was a pretty fast video for me. Like I said, I wanted to pare that down for you guys so that you could see just a few products that I'm immediately falling in love with. I am gearing up for the year end favorites, and I would love to know from you guys whether you would like me to do like face products, eye products, lip products, skin, that kind of thing, or if you just want me to just throw it all into one video. It would be a really long video if I did it in just one. So I know I'm gonna have to split it apart, but you let me know if you would like to see makeup all in one, skincare all in one, maybe hair care with the skincare tools. Let me know how in the past you've enjoyed other influencers doing it. Kind of help me with some ideas for what would be good for my channel here. And I do appreciate all of your help as always, and thank you so much for watching today. I appreciate every single one of you. Please take care of yourselves, and I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye, my friends.